smoke a prototype. A betting man wouldn't go and roll the dice. Snake eyes, you know your broken side. Like a cobra bite, you won't survive. Nah, tall orders come in short supply. Big boy straight out of Jotunheim. They know that I can hold the line. Don't go, I'll be your go-to guy. This whole damn showroom's overpriced. And I'm...
What's up, everybody? I'm Skullz, and today we're checking out Ticks and Leeches by Tool. We're just coming off of Parabol and Parabola. Holy crap, amazing songs. Every song has just been incredible on this album. I don't know if it's where I am in my life right now. Maybe that's why it's resonating so much with me, or maybe because I'm very interested in psychology or philosophy. I don't know. But this album's just hitting me, and it's hitting me in all the right spots. But I will say about the previous songs, I see why you guys wanted me to listen to them together. That's one song. I mean, the lyrics literally bleed into each other. I can't even imagine listening to those songs separately. Like, they have to go together. Just like Eon Blue, Apocalypse, and The Patient. They're just perfectly integrated with each other. Same with Mantra and Schism. I don't listen to those songs without the intermissions. The intermissions are much more relevant, much more atmospheric, and much more vital. In Anima, I don't listen to the intermissions. I think the only one that I have listened to is, I think it is literally called Intermission, the one before Jimmy. Besides that, no other intermissions I listen to. This album has just been compelling from the start. The pacing, the themes, the narrative, the lyrical abilities, the growth in all of the band members. I keep saying it, but there is so much evolution happening here. In considering where Tool has come from narratively, this is so compelling, it's so enlightening, it's so earned, and it's so rewarding. This album might end up being one of my favorites of all time. We will see. But for this one, I'm thinking with the title the way it is, I think this is gonna be a more aggressive song. I mean, we haven't had a song like The Grudge since The Grudge. So, I'm thinking this is going to be aggressive Maynard, angry Maynard. And considering the topic of Parabol and Parabola, I'm thinking maybe this could be about how people are parasites to your energy, a newfound positive perspective. People want to take that away from you because misery loves company. But anyways, I won't waste any more time. Let's hop right into this. But first, if you're new here, consider hitting the like button, the subscribe button, the notification bell. Helps the channel grow, helps the video reach more people, and I appreciate it a lot. Oh no. Oh my God. Okay, Danny needs to cool it, and so does Maynard. This is incredibly busy work from Danny. This dude's stamina and coordination is unbelievable. And I think the time signature, at least at the beginning, was 1-2-3, 1-2-3-4. Again, amazing work from Adam. And this almost sounds sonically Hooker with a Penis Part 2. But the lyrics? Suck and suck, sucking up all you can. Sucking up all you can suck and suck. Working up under my patience like a little tick, fat little parasite. Suck me dry, my fruit is bruised and borrowed. You thieving bastards. You have turned my blood cold and bitter. Beat my compassion black and blue. This song definitely feels along the lines of what I was saying at the beginning, what I thought it was going to be about. But it could be about a lot of different things. There's a lot of different types of parasitic energy. He could be talking about his fans. He could be talking about his negative emotions. This also could be a moment of relapsing back into his older behaviors. Still early in the song, I don't know where the narrative's going. My fruit is bruised and borrowed. What I'm thinking of is like the fruits of my labor, all my energy in trying to better myself and everything is not only getting overlooked, like I'm being told that it's not good. Like maybe this could be directed at the fans that don't like the direction he's going in. Maybe he's thinking like, oh, well, you guys want me to be this older version of myself that was self-sabotaging and was angrier and resentful. And it's like, you want me to be that person? Like, I don't want to be that person forever. I want to grow. I want to evolve. I want to be better for me, for the people around me. And I'm not going to let you take that away from me. Like I said in the previous song, this he's drawing his line in the sand and he's protecting his peace. But the lyrics continue. Hope this is what you wanted. Hope this is what you had in mind. Because this is what you're getting. I hope you're choking. I hope you choke on this. I hope you're choking. I hope you choke on this. Yeah, see, this sounds like it's directed towards the fans again, which would sort of make sense considering this sounds a lot like Hooker with a Penis. And Hooker with a Penis was directed directly at a fan. Like there was no mincing words. These lyrics sound a little bit more up for interpretation, but we'll see where it goes. There is such a sense of him stopping himself from falling into the same bad headspaces. Like it happened in Schism. Like the grudge was about letting things go. The patient was about not succumbing to your impatience. It was about waiting it out and seeing how things turned out. And then this song, they just took such a left turn. This song started up as such an angry song. And now it's just like giving you all this room to breathe and calm down from that. Let it go, move forward. But we'll go over the lyrics real quick. Taking all I can, taking all I can, I can take. Taking all you can, taking all you can, we can take. Got nothing left to give to you. Blood-sucking, parasitic little tick. Take what you want and then go. So there's almost this reciprocated parasitic thing where it's like if I engage you in your parasitic negative conflict, it's gonna drain me, it's gonna drain you. So it's better to just walk away because there's nothing that we're building if we do this. We're just destroying ourselves, destroying this conversation. There's no point to it. And that's why he says, take what you want and then go. It's like he's saying, I don't want to engage in this. Take what you want. Get out of here. That's it. But then the chorus again, hope this is what you wanted. Hope this is what you had in mind, because this is what you're getting. Very different outlook from F you, buddy. That was a wild song for Maynard and Danny, especially. You know, on any other album, I probably would have thought that middle section was too long. I mean, they really drew that out, where it was just the guitar kind of strumming and the bass coming in slowly, the drums coming in slowly. But with this song, it was a conscious decision just to basically just be in still water for a moment. And if it is about the fans not liking the direction of them going, that's hilarious, because that would probably bore those fans that just want him screaming and screaming. And then he does a song where he's screaming and screaming, giving them sort of what they want. and then pulls the rug out from underneath him, and then comes back in at the end. It feels sort of like a half troll. And honestly, that's a better way to deal with those type of people than to deal with them in a just flat out angry way. Like, troll them, have fun with them, play with them a little bit. But I don't know, that's what I got out of it. It definitely just feels like anyone in your life that's preying on your positive energy or preying on you and what you're doing in your life. People who do that usually have nothing going on in their life, which is precisely why I don't really care about the negative comments here. There are so many people who just type angry things on Twitter, YouTube, all social media platforms, and that's their life. And it's like, all I can do is feel bad for those people, because they're going to wake up one day and they're going to be 60 and they're going to be like, God, I messed this whole thing up. And you know what? They're not going to be able to point at me. They're not going to be able to point at Maynard and blame them. All you have at the end of the day is yourself, and that's who you're going to blame. So seriously, guys, if you have like ideas or aspirations or love for something, don't let them take that energy away. That's good energy. And as long as you're trying to tame it and discipline it and use it to build something, that energy is worthwhile. So forget those people and focus on your evolution. This was another great song. It works really well in context of the album. I don't know if this would be a 10 out of 10 for me, but it would be pretty close. I would maybe give this song a 9, a 9.5. Kind of leaning towards 9.5. It's just really weird because like when I started off this journey, I was like, I'm not gonna like this band when they get a little bit softer and more tribal, spiritual, or whatever. But I'm having a hard time going back to Undertow. I remember going from Undertow to Anima, and I was like, okay, this is a big change. I don't know if I'm gonna like this. I like it, but I feel like I liked Undertow more. And then as I listened to Anima, I was like, I can't even imagine Tool going in a different direction. And now here, it's the same way. I'm definitely liking them getting softer and more sophisticated. They can still do songs like this. Again, it felt like Hooker with a Penis, just with a better perspective on. The song even could have been less directed at the fans and more directed at the industry. But again, really spectacular song. I know I'm saying it's not a 10 for me necessarily, but bro, this is a incredible song. Like, this goes on my workout playlist right away. Like, I'm gonna be listening to this all the time. But yeah, guys, this was awesome. Every song leaves me super excited to make the next reaction video. If there's any context I'm missing from the song, please let me know in the comments. I would really appreciate the added insight. But until then, if you're new here, consider hitting the like button, the subscribe button, the notification bell. Helps the channel grow, helps the video reach more people, and I appreciate it a lot. And wherever you are, I hope you're having a good day, good night, and as always, I look forward to the next one. Peace.